A gym full of groundy, rocky things would be a perfect power leveling opportunity for my samurai otter. However, I don't know where this gym is. I just kept running straight back and forth from the Pokemon Center to the cold storage. The storage of cold viruses. I don't know why you'd store that unless you're doing some kind of research, I guess. I don't know. Oh. It's always something, isn't it? There's gotta be some kind of story event before you get into your gym. My associates who are in your care. Oh, that's right, the captured plasma members. What? No. Okay. Just, yeah. Hop through the hoops of whatever plot contrivance you wish. I mean, yeah, they've got a whole bunch of members. Sharon and I could probably beat all of those members, again, if they would just stick to the Bruce Lee fighting rules and attack us one at a time. But we'll, you know, for the sake of advancing story and plot, we'll say that, you know, they outnumber you and we can move on with life. That's all you people think about. Really, if you were to replace these people's obsession with Pokemon with the real world's obsession with sex, you would just end up with the real world. Yeah. Flawless victory. Don't take a single hit point of damage during any battle that you have in this gym. I'm as strong as I think I can usefully get. And this would be a really nice hyper-leveling opportunity for Patchy anyway. So, we'll poke my nose in. Probably safe just do that much. Reception? Elevators. Is that the whole gimmick? Just elevators? Mm-hmm. I stocked up on those from the vending machine outside of town. Water type attacks. Yeah, it makes me wonder, hearts torn asunder, for this massive blunder. Wum, 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 wum. Ah, I see. A pit mine. This is a mine shaft. That's the, yep. Hence we have a gimmick. Worker Felix. Not the same type of worker. Hey! What happened to being a ground type? But that's the MO so far, isn't it? It's absolutely this game blindsiding you with a... Oh shoot, I forgot to turn the moves back on. In order to make my level grinding more time efficient, I turn off the effects. I'll turn that back on. Yeah. This, during my recent leveling session, though, I did not level Patchy at all. And this will be a really good opportunity to do that. Just like, I don't care if I get Patchy up to like level 50. That'd be totes fine. That'd be toot sweet. Down, down, down we go. No way to stop. As you fall, hear me call, no, no, no. Yeah. I'm thinking there's no way that we could possibly have a safe Pokemon battle on these tiny, narrow steel girders here in the top of an endless mineshaft pit. What are you guys mining here anyway? Is it just clay? As such, your boss's name is, you're mining clay? It doesn't sound very special, but clay is indeed a commodity. It's a cheap commodity, but it still is one. You can make pottery out of it. Damn, son, this might be too easy. Well, at least I'm not in the position of knowing that I am in the position of knowing that I'm not going to lose anybody, probably. Don't get your frickin' panties up in a proud little bunch knot, UD. Lost my spirits all the way down. Dude, how many times does the OSHA handbook have to specify the procedure for not losing your spirits, dude? I mean, it says, like, keep two contact points of spirit in contact with your scaffolding equipment at all times. Oh, shizbiz. Start over. Well, I may as well go freshen up, Patchy. You don't have to take every elevator you step on. You can walk on the girders. Like so. What? When I face my Pokemon, we share real feelings. Sometimes that's what I do in this gym. Just so long as you do it out in the open. Oh, you think you're so awesome. What is strong against ground except for water? Almost certainly nothing that I have access to right now. Oh, that's gotta hurt your feelings, dude. I took your super-powered crocodile and I just razor-sliced them all down to one. Instantly. Just like the samurai, the law-abiding peacekeeper that my otter is. I have to move another elevator down, don't I? By the way, what's a salary man doing here? I'm pretty sure that there's nobody ever in a clay pit who's dressed like a salaryman. Man, I feel bad. Just like, you bring one samurai otter into the clay pit and you're just endlessly myrtleizing every single thing you come into contact with. Yes, it is easy. It's mindlessly numb-stompingly insane. Level 40. Clerk, okay. I mean, clerks are still technically salarymen, right? These water types are a bit weird, but you're still low enough level that I can just do this absolutely thoughtlessly. Oh, please. If I were impressed, my name would be Raw Stress for Less. Man. I'm reminded of another time when I was able to completely fight without thinking. And that time was when I had gained a shield and a rod. Like a particular combination of armaments. When used at the same time, they would allow you to simply walk face first into your foe while dealing ridiculous amounts of damage and healing yourself in the process. I'm supposed to get another elevator to go down. Come on, this is a Pokemon gym puzzle. They're not this hard. Yeah, I gotta meet that salary worker woman. There's no elevator over there. Oh, but there is one over up and to the far left. Okay. So this is the way to win Nuzlocke, huh? Is just be so strong that you utterly, completely demolish everything that has the hubris to look in the same direction as what you're currently standing in. Clerk. Now, she's an OL. Also known as the most attractive non-obscene thing ever, the office lady. You see, 29 there, that's supposed to be high level for this point in the game right now. Is it? It's not about skill, lady. Or maybe it is. If you go grind up skills in the wilderness for 40 years like I did. But, Jesus Christ, with tacos and spice. In this video, I may have learned the second half of the nature essence of Nuzlocke. The first half is getting your hopes and dreams completely shattered. The second half is to just win effortlessly because you put in the grinding time. Whee! Change of gravitational forces and fossils. Why are those still there? How have we not excavated those and sent them to a museum? It was Indy Jones who quite wisely said that that belongs in a museum. And it does. Also, crystal? You have a... So it's not clay that you're mining here. There's some kind of weirdo green crystal that you're mining. Also, if I wait long enough, will the stuff on those conveyor belts get taken up the stair-stepper? Let me see. I'm gonna watch. Oh, it does. Nice little detail. Nice little detail. Okay, Clay. I've got a level 40 otter. Can you deal with that shizbiz? Well, I think it's about time. Yeah. Toko versus Clay! To be near the Clay! You're a cowboy. Yeah. Color me intimidated. Like, I'm sorry. I had one of you. I know what you're about. And you are about getting samurai sorted into the dust. Yeah, see? That can't have been good for your self-esteem, Clay. I'm sorry. Excadrill. That is going to be the evolved version of Drillbur, isn't it? Yikes. That is one mean-looking mole. Not me no more. Palpitoad. I don't really have a good weapon for water, do I? I mean, other than Patchy himself. I mean, Stemmy's also very strong. I can just switch him out just to let another Pokemon battle a little bit. You're also a third level Evo now, too. Right, I guess I should say a second Evo. You know. Wait, what? This is your last Pokemon? Color me disappointed. I thought your last... Oh, God. That is nowhere near as depressing as losing and, you know, getting my whole team cut down to a single member, but that's still kind of sad. I don't think I took a single hit point of damage that entire gym leader fight. Dig up my potential. All that's needed for that is a dedication to World of Warcraft. You know, when a video starts, I'm doomed to have some kind of hideous mispronunciation problem. I'll wake up a little bit more and feel bad, but... Wait, what? I don't need any hidden machine or technical machine from you, except if the game gates me into needing it. But... Grinding like World of Warcraft is what I was going to say. That was disappointingly easy. Yeah. So, I knew that that was going to be impossible. I knew that if I grind enough, I'd win, but then that would just make it so, oh, I'm just pressing the A button over and over again, and that makes Nuzlocke doable after you put in, you know, many, 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 many hours of grinding. I resolved, regardless of that potential outcome, to finish this. I promised I would finish this, no matter if the rest of these videos are going to be boring ass shit nonsense. Oh, now we're going to do this again, huh? I should have expected this. Yeah, of course. We just hit another milestone, so that means I've got to combat with my friends once again. Watch my poor girlfriend as she's knocked off balance by the simple task of pulling a Pokeball out of her purse. I wonder if I shouldn't take her to a hospital for some kind of hailstones. For some kind of rehab is what I was thinking. Not like drug addiction rehab, but more like the, you know, I just got into a car accident and shattered my pelvis and now I can't walk kind of rehab. Poor her, dear. Yeah. Hey! I thought only gym leaders would do that. Actually, no. We saw Sharon do berries earlier, didn't we? There we go. Yes, I will switch. To whom would be a switch? You know, I realize now that a decent weapon that I would have had against grass types, I don't really have. Because water is weak against grass, so I can't really use decoy. Blast a million. Okay. We'll put out a chinchilla for just a moment. I think I'm going to get to evolve this chinchilla, if I want to. There's a... the method of doing this is with a clear stone. Wait. That's the move where I can't use the same turn, or the same move multiple turns in a row, right? Yeah. Yeah. Dang. That keeps me from using the effective portion of Echoed Voice. It gets stronger the more you use it. As I was trying to say, I've resolved to finish this no matter what, but even if I end up having to talk about complete nonsense for the entire rest of the video series, hey, there you go. But, now I completely forgot where I was going to go with that because the game kept interrupting me. Oh well. Oh yeah. It might... Actually, shitfire! Stop! Oh, god damn it! No! Fuck! Ah! Son of a fucking bitch. You gotta pay attention! Loose lips sink ships. I hate myself so much. Just be gone, pork roast Ella, stupid. I like that chinchilla. God damn it. Yeah, you... Oh. I was waiting for that, HM. You wouldn't be so cavalier about it, Belle, if you knew. Fuck Nuzlocke, man. I kept trying to say I would resolve to finish this. I resolved to finish this just so long as I focus on the fight and not continually get distracted enough to make stupid mistakes. So fly is a great move, and it's one that's very good at keeping your Pokemon alive, actually. I looked up this bird's stats, and it actually seems to be like perfectly balanced between physical and special attack power. So the one that's slightly more... This one's got better hit rate, but meh. Fly is a really good move. And it'll help keep Decoy alive, unlike my beloved chinchilla, who is now dead. Loose lips, sink ships. Well, I was hoping I would get right back up to a team of six. I mean, I still have Arnold, the timber, but goddamn, I don't want to use it. It's too freaking ugly. Anyway. Yeah, that music, victorious, awesome. That's not how I'm feeling right now. pre-battle declaration. If I step into this tall grass and it's a timber, I'm just going to faint it. I don't want it. I already have one, but if it's anything else, I'll try to catch it. Of course, fainting that timber means that I will have forfeited my right to try to catch something on this route, but that's the rules. God damn it, I like that chinchilla. Motherfucker. Ooh. Is this the pre-evolved version of Levany? Swadloon. Oh. It's not gonna get you anywhere, Leafy Bro, sorry. There you go. Critical hit. Oh, hey. Hey, don't do something you can't take back, okay? Razor Leaf has already caused enough heartache in this run. The hail? Yes, the hail! It was still hailing. Oh. Fuck yeah, son of a bitch. So what's today's lesson? Don't get cocky, ever. Because a Nuzlocke will just slap your shit right back down. A Deerling? Why couldn't I have caught that? Fuck you, Nuzlocke, I hate you. I hate you so much. Oh well. Let's take this opportunity to see how my nice new move looks. Why am I buffeted by... Well, it's... Decoys in the air, I guess. Oh, you're a grass type. I thought you were just a normal type. I mean, grass is fine, too. I'd still love to have a Deerling. Why are you out here? Are you a botanist? A zoologist? Botanist. God damn it. So the moral balancing drive of my brain is telling me now that in order to make up for losing Izzy, I need to go, like, buy a Minchino plush or something. I need to make it up to myself. Moral balancing is really stupid. It's a thing our brains do, and it's really awful. Awful and dumb. See, I only did that because I know that my swan is faster than your deer. But if it wasn't, for all I know, you would have used Razor Leaf against me and ended my entire life! Motherfucking hellfiring shit feces. Oh. Okay. Like, you do what you want to do. All I'm interested in is finding another route, like another area. Because my team is down to a nasty level of incompleteness again, and I want more Pokemon! Uh-oh. Oh, no good at all. One electric attack would take my poor bird out, almost certainly, so... yeah, this worked really well in a prior gym. So... Why don't Nuzlocke have a more infamous reputation? Or maybe they do, and I'm just not aware of it. Because I'm getting, like, a negative reputation here on many ends. Like, my experience so far with it has been really damn negative. And only after I started this run did I start hearing of people telling me, you know, fuck Nuzlocke, here's all the reasons why they suck and they're stupid, meh. Which, okay. Yeah, switch. But given like the negative experience that these variety of conditions can cause, I'm wondering why I don't hear of it like just being entirely discredited. It seems at first like it'd be like a really interesting challenge run condition, but it's just... It seems like very much nonsense, honestly. It's either get your testicles completely squoze out of your very being with the uttermost pain you could possibly think of, or overlevel your team into the stratospheres of godliness and be utterly unstoppable. It's completely binary between those two. And that's not really good for challenge, honestly. That's just... yeah. The opposite of challenge, whatever that is. It's either impossible or far, far too easy. And that's not challenge. Challenge is that sweet, sweet middle ground. I don't know how to hit that sweet, sweet middle ground, but it's starting to seem like Nuzlocke isn't it. So, do I risk committing myself to the Concord fallacy at this point? For those who aren't familiar, Concord fallacy is named, well, you can probably just frickin' Google it, and I don't have to explain it and be all patronizing in the process. But, I will, just for the lazier of us. I know I'm lazy and I like to have things explained to me. The Concord fallacy talks about a certain government, I think it was a French government, who was trying to make the supersonic passenger jet of the Concord. The project gets way out of hand, becomes far more expensive in money and time and manpower than anybody thought it would be. But the government decides to keep throwing money and manpower and time after it, because if we don't, then all the resources we've dumped into it up to this point become wasted. That's the Concord fallacy. It's throwing good money after bad, or good time after bad. Oh, son of a bitch. I'll risk one more hit. So, how does that apply here? Say if I continue on Nuzlocke run simply because I'm like, well, I have to, because if I don't, then all the time I've spent up to this point and all the effort I put up to this point will be wasted! And so I waste more and more and more and more time trying to justify the time I spent previously, and it's just... it doesn't. It's a fallacy. It doesn't make any sense. It's a natural fallacy. It's something that we're emotionally engaged in doing, like, naturally, but it's not logically correct. Do I risk succumbing to that? Hey, scientist. Hi. Quiet because I'm thinking. I'm like trying to mentally unravel the secrets of Nuzlocke. Deck-a-so, na-na-na-na-na-na. Oh, whoops. This is gonna be another Audino, isn't it? Yeah. Every time it's one of these shaky bushes, it's always an Audino. I would think there would be like a unique Pokemon for every root, but it's always an Audino, weirdly. Also, every time one of these Audinos show up, if you faint it, you get like 5 or 6 times the normal experience, so it's very good for level grinding. Ow, ow. So, Nuzlocke being famous is a challenge run condition. Famous doesn't mean good. We all know that. I mean, just look at any aspect of any popular culture. Famous does not mean good. You know another thing that's really popular but not good? The Pokemon anime. Oh, god damn. I hate that show so much. What do you think, dear viewer? Do you have some preconceived notions, or now currently conceived notions of Nuzlocke regarding its quality or lack thereof as a challenge condition? Shit gets me wondering, man. Yeah, there's no secret to my power. It's just going into the woods to train for years on end. You know, I'm tempted to put it up to a vote. I am. I don't know what the vote would be. It would be some kind of either-or condition, like continue the Nuzlocke and finish it somehow or another, or do this instead, and I don't know what that other thing would be just yet. I remember when it came to taking a flail whip in La Mulana, I put it to a vote, and I asked, hey, should I do X or should I do Y? I'll do what the viewers say, because I want to continue to have fun with this product, but not if it means doing this or this. I think I know. What the question should be at first, which I would really, really like viewer input on, is... Dear viewer, respond to this if you would, please. I feel like we have aptly shown that Nuzlocke is one of two things. It is either pissingly easy with just repeatedly pressing the A button over and over again until you fall asleep, or it's getting your heart torn out in front of your still living eyes and having the heart thrown into a hide flesher while you watch. It's one of those two. There's really no middle ground. Which might mean that just, you know... Oh. First time I've seen this, I think. Which might mean that just the mathematics are not on Nuzlocke's side. It's either far too easy or heart-crushingly insane, and there's no happy middle ground. I don't know, it's my impression that we've shown that pretty damn aptly in these few videos so far. So the question should be, dear viewer, do you agree with that assessment? Do you agree with that assessment? Do you agree that Nuzlocke is binary? It's either impossible and soul-breaking, or it's boring and easy. It's one of those two. That's my view. Tell me if you agree. As many comments as possible on this. I really, really want to know what you think. And just so that people don't possibly miss it during the length of this video, I'm going to stick that in the description as well, so it's very difficult to miss. I know ice is strong against flying, but I knew I was also faster than the Vanillite, so that was not a risk. Frillish. Is that an evolved version? No, it's a plant, I think? Is that seaweed? Is that like water grass? It looks like water grass. No. Oh, I'm not satisfied. I'm much less than satisfied right now. So, viewer, tell me what you think. And if enough people think that Nuzlocke is necessarily one of those two things, like, that's the yes or no I'm looking for. It's either yes, it is one of those two things, or the other option is no, Nuzlocke actually is a good challenge condition, UD, and you should just stop your frickin' whining and go through and finish the thing. That's the either or I'm looking for. If enough people agree with me that Nuzlocke isn't a good challenge run condition because it's all or nothing, if enough people agree with me to that end, then the next question I might have to ask is, well, now what? Chargestone Cave. Oh, well, here's a place where I can try to catch something at least. Grinding patch. Can Cut get through a spider web? Bah. I wasn't waiting. I just barely got here, and you followed up behind me. I could have done that too, you know. I have a crocodile who makes your little sand alligator look crocodile look like nothing. Bulldoze. I'll doze your bulls. Yeah. I've decided that I was too limited to be limited. I suppose I can try to catch something in this cave. Getting an electric type would be nice. Oh, not you again. Oh, damn it. Ninjas. What? Here, I brought the one you wanted. Why, hello. Yes, I'm Nibiru. That was the Shadow Triad. There's only two of them. That would make them a Shadow Duo. But I guess it's just like the whole club is called the Triad, just like a Chinese gang, right? No, it doesn't, because you also, chose me to go on a mystery Ferris wheel ride with you. You just freaked the hell out of me, dude, that's all. Yeah, I know you're gonna fight me again. Can we just get to it? What? You've run away? WTF, Gladstone. I'm not gonna get close to the sparkly warklies if I can help it. Guess what? It's still in Breakers. Oh. Why are you here? There's no way you could have known I was gonna be here. Also, this is a long trip. Why did you get all the way here? Like, Ninchino can't fly. I don't feel lucky. I just feel like I'm further and further committing to the Concord fallacy. You have to protect it. Hey, don't go getting a crush on the older girl. You're spoken for, girl. What the hell is that thing? Clink? It's steel type, isn't it? I'll be damned. I haven't had a steel type so far. I don't think I've ever had a steel type at all outside of Gen 6. And the only steel type I had then was a Mawile. Huh. I'll catch it. I'll try anyway. Yeah. So normal's not very effective against steel, right? That's okay. Oh shit, it's electric too? Oh, goddamn, okay. Didn't hurt very much. Patchy's very, very strong. That should be good enough, right? One more. I can't faint it. All I'm worried about is that guy unleashing, like, Thunderbolt or something similarly ridiculous. Like Charge. There's a good example. Now, I don't care if you charge power, because I'm going to throw a Heal Ball at you, and your entire life will be over. Just get beholden to the Concord fallacy, just like I'm doing right now. A steel type. By the way, steel electric or just steel? Just steel. Two bunnies spin around, generates the energy they need to live. That is not how thermodynamics works. There has to be some energy source that spun the gears in the first place. All right, Colonel Clink. That's perfect. Colonel Clink. Yeah, I didn't even know what nickname to give this thing, but now I do. You are now the Colonel. Is that how you spell Colonel? Colonel? Yeah, that's how you spell Colonel. I'm pretty sure. Colonel. Colonel. Colonel! Oh, you're just Okay, well, you said we could move these things by touching them, right? Oh, okay. Well, that was just grand on several scales. Should probably manage my team a bit. Do I have any repels? No, I don't. I should have gotten some. I'm gonna get hit all up in the face with so many random encounters. A Joltik? Ah! Why couldn't I have caught that thing? God damn it! I hate Nuzlocke. I didn't before, but I do now. Oh god, I hate Nuzlocke. Pharaoh Seed. Grass Steel? Very weird. A psychic type is the only one I would have that could deal with that, don't I? Man, I'm running into all these interesting Pokemon I can't catch. This is making me unhappy. Not very effective. Psychic. What are you, and why is Psychic not hurting you all that well? Oh well. Be pushed. And magnetized, apparently. Is that what the blue sparkling indicates? Just magnetics? Ooh. Bulldurr. Oh, I think you're the evolution of Roggenrola, aren't you? Poor Balboa. Okay, so that doesn't actually hurt me. I like looked at my health bars and nothing has dropped. Yeah, it's probably just a magnetic field with no other really real impulse. Ooh, I do have some repels, thank goodness. They just weren't in the medicine case. Just something I should have obviously realized upon retrospect. Good, now I can actually get through here sometime in the next, you know, forever. Oh, damn it. I don't think I do. Because I'm operating with the unique disadvantage that nobody else here has. Archon. I saw one of these things in Super Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. And I know it of it nowhere else. Ow. What? So I've got to hit you now. Now! Don't go making me scared for my otter, okay? I've had enough heartbreak as it is. There, finally. You get samurai'd, son. You see? What do you see? Yeah, okay. You'll need to get 6 Pokemon before you can realistically take on that dream, dude. Push! Except I can't because I want to push you away from one of the magnetizing crystals, huh? Can I do this without getting seen by the scientist? Play Metal Gear Solid in a Pokemon game? Yeah, no go. Well, huh. How does one advance if you're named Jack Valance? Oh, you can step up here, Herpaderpa. Can I push you both down? Nope, not both at once. But I can push one of you out. There we go. And then push the other one down. You see, that's pretty cool. I like fun dungeon mechanics. Oh god, what now? Hi there. Data to prove it. So So you're a professor. That would make me think that you, like, you teach things. You're not, like, a field biologist. I mean, it's not that professors don't do research. Do professors study in the field? I don't know that much about academia, to be brutally honest. So they might study in the field, and I wouldn't know about it. I always thought that they were the kind of people who might study in a lab, or who might, this has got to be a higher level dude. No, it's not. What the hell? Nah. Oh, here we go again. You know, there's a professor and a love interest right behind me. They are. I don't want to deal with them right now. Like, I could not be less interested if I were more interesting. Yeah. Hi, lady person, student, professory type. Scientist, Naoko. I try to imagine what it would be like to have a clink plush. Like, how could you make a clink plush without having the thing fall apart? I mean, obviously it couldn't spin. The two gears couldn't work against each other. They'd be static and stuck in place. Snore. Yeah, I'm sorry, dudes, but this is kind of bad. Charge beam. Sure, what does charge beam do? Electric? Oh, that's just what the colonel wants to learn. Sure. Get rid of Thundershock, because it's all but useless. How do you know? Because Pikachu knows it. You gotta distance yourself from that loser. Yep, here we go. Time for our Team Plasma encounter, right? Well, after I manage some shizbiz. I have a ton of repels. And by a ton, I mean three more. Whoa. Stuff goes down a ways. Oh, twin battle. Snooze. I snooze and you lose. Although I don't know the otherwise quickest way through here. I can't get by without getting caught by you two, can I? Oh, I can. Well, how about that? Except I can't push all these at one. Oh, I just walk under them too. Okay, I guess that works. That's a one way. So one should be careful, not get something dug up under your feet by a Pokemon who obviously wants to go like, hey, I know how to use Dig, I'm gonna make your whole life miserable. Nope. I stepped over it anyway. And look, yeah, this, oh, that was a return pipe. Mother fucking hellfire, god damn it. This can't be a very fulfilling life for you. Oh. Oh, you're a heal point, aren't you? Oh, but I have to fight you. Welp. Nothing gained unless something is sauteed. You can't earn at all unless you become a cook. There's just no other place for any profession or skill set in our economy. I see Team Plasma was like standing right up beyond you. You son of a jerk knob. I will psy-shock you back into the... Ugh, I'm not feeling very clever. I'm like, horrified of the Concord fallacy. I'm horrified of irrationality in general. And when I succumb to it, yes. I tell Nurse Joy she's got a nice butt. You never see it because she stands behind the counter the whole time, but... Oh boy, here we go. A gauntlet of plasmoids, huh? Son of a biscuit. I'm gonna run away from you because you just don't matter to me. You shouldn't matter to me. Just fairly faster than you, right? Yeah, there we go. Okay, Plasmon, give me what you got. Somebody manipulated me? No? Well, I mean, if you mean like physically manipulated me, sure. There was like a bunch of ninjas that grabbed me and like, come over here. I'll continue to make the pretense that I am leveling my poor gear set when I'm becoming increasingly convinced that this is a massive waste of time. Oh no. Don't be confused, Patchy. The charisma depends on you. Ow! Oh my god, the charisma! There. See how that backfired? My attack power was so high that I one-shotted you the exact same way I would have otherwise. Yep. You see what I mean here? I'm either like one-shotting everything in my wake, or I'm getting the shit kicked out of me. Both in the sense of, like, complete emotional exhaustion and losing in the video game. As a wise Vaporeon who I know would say, we are not winning the video game, guys. We are not winning the game. But, at least to the fruition of this video, let's press on. Mother fucking shit hot firing. I don't think anybody really likes random encounters. Sometimes it's a thing we put up with, but we don't really like it. Little did that guy know, I'm actually adhering to that rule long before he ever met me. Nah. Fighting a strong against dark. The power of friendship always prevails against evil, etc., etc. But dark is also strong against psychic. Man, there's a lot of really critical gaps in my team. Oh, that's right. Psychic just doesn't work against dark at all. Well, son of a bitch. On a Cisco switch. Decoy will use a weapon that I know is strong against fighting types. Flying. Goodbye. There, I didn't release Shizbiz, thank you. And don't go releasing your Scraggy, dude. He deserves better than that. Seems happy next to me. Yeah. That's complete and total projection on your part, dude. They absolutely do not. They could very well be right. Some of the most beautiful scenes in nature were, like, completely untouched by man until they had 4,000 tourists a day visiting them. Trubbish. Terrible Pokemon. I'd say even worse than Arnold. Please don't tell me you're also a dark type. No? Yeah, switch. Ain't no dark type here, be a dark type here, be. That was not an actual sentence. If you try to diagram it, the paper will fall into a black hole and you will kill all of us. So please do not diagram that non-sentence. No, plasma! Ah, yeah. Still, every time I've failed in battle, I have not screamed at the top of my lungs, UD! Although maybe I should. Maybe that's the thing I should start doing. Really? Worried about? I'm the trainer that is worried about? Not the one that he touches himself to at night? Because he sure acts like it. You're a bag of garbage. You're like a complete sack of trash, you know that? I wish that were an insult, but it's just like stating a literal fact. Meh. My give-a-shits are very rapidly running out, so I'm not leveling the kernel as diligently as one should be. Is this video itself not like an example of the Concord fallacy? It just might be. So you have three sacks of garbage as your companion fighters. This cannot be good for your self-esteem, girl. Are you high? Have you not been watching the complete curb stomp destruction, destructothons that have been happening all around you? Absolutely better than the trainers around here. Except when it really matters, and then I lose, like, instantly, and be really sad about it for days afterwards. Yeah, proud member. Show me the end, okay? This dungeon is outworn its welcome. Get a nice sandy crocodile out and enjoy some fun times and happy feelings. That's not what I wanted to have happen. But I guess you could just at will, like, put any member of my team to sleep, couldn't you? So I could, like, use an awakening on my guy right now and it wouldn't do a damn thing. Oh, status restore, herp derp. I don't have any of the berries that awaken, but I have a spray. Good Christ! There's no way that could normally be that strong. That has to be just like a move that halves your current amount of HP. There's no way you have a move that could do that much damage without it being super effective. Oh yeah, Switch. Pecan's been hurt too badly. Even if it's against the really crappy version of yourself, you'd probably be safe against. You know what occurs to me? This, attempting to Nuzlocke Pokemon White here is like the first time that I've really tried to record and get footage of a DS game. And the video capture and the engineering of the video was something that had intimidated me before. But this might, if nothing else, be like a really decent tech demo to show that now DS games are completely fair game. And there's a lot of really good DS games. Yeah. Whee! How does Steel and Dark match up? I'm sure they just, like, don't, right? I understand that the Dark type was introduced mostly to balance Psychic, because Psychic was, like, ridiculously, stupidly overpowered in Generation 1. And given my, you know, nearly like 15, 16, 17 year hiatus from this series of games. I didn't know how true that was until I went back to play Pokemon Red when it came out for the Virtual Console on my 3DS. Thank you, Colonel. Hey, this is, you're too strong. Huh? It's not fair. It's not fair. Just get yourself a Kadabra, or even evolve it into an Abracadabra, and the game's basically over. My shit, Psychic is overpowered in that game. Can I very gingerly walk around you so that you don't engage a fight with me? Ow, ow, ow. Where's N? You guys said N would be down here, huh? I feel rather endless. Endless and endless and endless. Gotta be down here somewhere, right? I'm just finding these items I don't care about. Oh. But I can artificially force a level into the kernel now. It's not here. Oh, yep, there it is. So wrong I was in everything I've ever done. And the colonel's strong enough that he might be able to fight for himself now. If, you know, a pair of floating interlocked gears even has a gender, which I'm not convinced that it does or could. Eh. Oh, Christ. I'm out of repels. Dang. Blast a million sesquitillion. And where are you? Come. I need to be done with this dungeon. Oh. So the downstairs was just a diversion all along. I actually have to go upstairs to meet Anne again. Okay. Well, I'll put this peon aside, I suppose. Do you know how many of your ilk I have ilked this ilk? Again, with the non-sentences. This is something you should be very angry about. Your opponent doesn't even want to speak properly. How does that make you feel? Yeah. Yeah. My poor samurai is frequently confused. See? Just whacked himself in the face with his own paw. That's not something a normal person does. But this is Swesh. Yeah, may as well. Switch to a bird. An absurd bird whose word was heard. I'm sorry, I just put that terrible song in your head and in mine. I was just trying to come up with the normal sing-songy rhymes that I do, but it backfired on me horribly. OP, son of a watchdog. Well, bird leveled up. That's pretty cool. Very good at using Pokemon. No, no, I'm not. You're just even worse than I am. Alright, so I smell an N up here. Is an N up here? You're not N. Oh, you're N, though. As the world becomes angry, that is unforgivable. I will separate... Hmm. Yeah, I do. But it involves, like, a mosh pit full of oiled-up bikini wrestlers. Sure. Nincompoop. Nimbus Cloud. Not sanctioned by the UN. Oh my. Probably wasn't good to have, like, my weakest party member out at first, so I necessarily have to take a hit to get switched into an optimal position. That's right, Patchy. You're now going to take a smack on the face for our poor little colonel. Oh, except not. Now here's the question. Will that matter? Probably not. Oh, except you can't be one-shot. Forgot. Yeah. Oh well. Haha, completely useless. I could even use Cut on you now and still do a single hit point worth of damage. See? Ka-chink. But Patchy's done enough fighting and deserves to be healed. Oh, a Joltik? Yep, switch, sorry. You caught a Joltik in here. Son of a bitch, I wanted to catch a Joltik. Such a cute little power bug that I have to completely mercilessly destroy. I could have used a ground type move on you, but I'm not that smart. Anything I do would probably be sufficient, right? That's right. A Pharaoh Seed. That is so weird. It's a special attack that I'm using against you, not a physical one. You do not impress me in the least. Not even a little bit. I tried. I got like my impressometer and you rated like a 000.000. Oh, I don't know. Switch to something, I guess. I don't know how flying and steel match up to each other. Let's find out. You're very poetic and sing-songy, but... Or at least you try to be poetic, but you just come across as complete nonsense. Oh, shoot, that's right. You have electric moves. Yeah, which means... Oh, fuck, I just lost my bird, didn't I? Son of a bitch. Oh, I didn't. Oh, phew. Okay, well, back to the ground type, I guess. Now, let's see. I think ground is strong against steel. Let's see if that's true. Nothing hurts. Pain don't hurt. It's been clinically proven. Doko! Oh my god! Thank god I've saved you! Who is this trainer? Well, he's been horn-dogging on me hardcore, but he, like, read far too much Edgar Allan Poe growing up, and now he's trying to be all, like, brooding and introspective about it, but he doesn't realize that I am so gay! I am incredibly gay! I, like... One of those mythical manga lesbians you hear about, like just in Japanese comics, who are so gay that they turn other women gay. I realize that doesn't happen. Okay. Wait. So you do feel like you have to explain yourself to me. I'm gonna go because I'm her bodyguard. So you do feel like you have to explain yourself to me. Ah. This place has a really happy tune. So what did we learn in this video? I came to the conclusion that Nuzlocks are stupid. The math does not add up to make a fun, engaging experience. So, mostly right now, I want to know, do you agree?